Welcome, Noiristas, to the last Noir Alley of 2019. I'm Father Time, a.k.a. Eddie Muller, and I have a very special show for you today. We are going to celebrate New Year's a bit early with a film that opens significantly on New Year's Eve. It's repeat performance made by Eagle Lion Films in 1947. Making the occasion even more special is that in the 25-year history of Turner Classic Movies, this is the first time repeat performance has been shown. Not that the film is forgotten, especially by those who saw it on its initial release. In my avocation as a noirchaeologist, digging up obscure and neglected examples of film noir, this is probably the lost film I've been asked about more than any other. There's two reasons for that. First, it's got a hook that's a real grabber, one that nudges the film from the crime genre into the realm of the supernatural. On New Year's Eve, something dreadful happens to Broadway actress Sheila Page, something that will surely destroy her life. But a mysterious warp in time allows Sheila to relive the previous year with the hope that her repeat performance will have a different ending. I've often called this a noir variation of It's a Wonderful Life. Now, the other reason people ask about this film is that it had seemingly vanished. For decades, the movie was only a memory in people's minds, and folks began thinking that they'd imagined the movie. That's how far into obscurity it had fallen. But in 2007, I finally managed to track down a 35mm print to screen at my Noir City Film Festival. And even better, Joan Leslie, the film's star, agreed to appear at the screening. So imagine my chagrin when that print, which only arrived the day of the show, turned out to be a decomposing mess. Well, thanks to a collector pal with a 16mm copy, the show went on. But after that, I was determined to rescue the film from oblivion. And thanks to the Film Noir Foundation, the UCLA Film and Television Archive, and the Packard Institute for the Humanities, you now get to see repeat performance in its restored and resurrected glory. And soon, in cooperation with our colleagues at Flickr Alley, TCM, and Films Around the World, it will be available on Blu-ray and DVD. So here's the backstory of this unique movie. Eagle Lion Pictures was a British outfit owned by movie mogul J. Arthur Rank. In 1946, he created an American subsidiary by merging with Poverty Row Studio Producers Releasing Corporation, PRC. The idea was to make low-budget B-movies to play on double bills with imported British films. Brian Foy, who'd managed Warner Brothers' B-unit in the 1930s, was made head of production at Eagle Lion. And Foy marshaled some formidable producing talent for this modest operation. Aubrey Skenk, Walter Wanger, and Eddie Small were all innovative independent producers who joined the fold. Foy decided to get a bit more ambitious when Eagle Lion purchased the 1942 novel Repeat Performance, written by William O'Farrell. Initially, it was a package deal with French Hotone to star and Gilda screenwriter Marion Parsonet to write and produce. Constance Dowling was set for the role of Sheila Page, but after small parts in a couple of films, including swell noirs like Black Angel and Blindspot, Dowling became disillusioned with Hollywood and moved to Italy. Sylvia Sidney then agreed to the role, doing screen tests and signing off on Parsonet's script. Foy announced that Jules Dassin would direct. But in October of 1946, Brian Foy bought out Parsonet's interest in the film, which ended Franchitone's involvement as well. Aubrey Skenk was assigned to produce, and Foy replaced Jules Dassin with Alfred Werker. Meanwhile, Joan Leslie had taken Warner Brothers to court to get out of her contract, which she'd signed in 1942 when she was only 17. Leslie had been typed as a sweet ingenue, but now that she was legal, 21 years of age, she was itching to play grown women. And even before the courts granted her freedom from what she called indentured servitude to Warners, Leslie signed with independent Nero Pictures to star opposite Robert Cummings in The Chase. But Warner Brothers got an injunction preventing her from doing that film, and she was replaced by French actress Michelle Morgan. Finally, in 1946, Leslie was released from her Warners contract by a Superior Court decision. She signed a two-picture deal with Eagle Lion, and replaced Sylvia Sidney in repeat performance. Foy figured that all the hoopla surrounding Leslie would give the picture a boost, but it also meant bringing in writer Walter Bullock to completely retool the screenplay to fit the new star's image, which I'll explain after the movie.
Oh, Bonnie, I'm suddenly so happy. I don't remember being this happy before.
You'll get used to it.
Lewis Hayward was signed for the role of Sheila's husband, Barney Page. The South African actor had come to prominence in England as a protege of Noel Coward's, and after moving to Hollywood in the 1930s, his marriage to Ida Lupino raised his profile even further. But service with the Marines during World War II, which included filming the infamous Battle of Tarawa, left Hayward shell-shocked. After his homecoming, he was a different man, and he and Lupino became combatants, which, frankly, seemed to have influenced his portrayal of actor Barney Page. Repeat performance also marked the film debut of actor Richard Basehart, playing a poet with the odd name William Williams. It's a fine performance, but if he played the character as written in the book, it would have broken new ground in Hollywood. Explanation in about 90 minutes. Right now, Noir Alley is proud to present the TCM premiere of Repeat Performance.